and friends. And she took me on her wings. At college, Anna made numerous friends, but there were three of us who met simultaneously, became instant friends, and formed a lifelong relationship. There was Grace Straw Taylor, who is now deceased. She met her demise much earlier in life. There was Anna, and there was myself. We were known as the three musketeers. Whenever you saw one, you saw the others. Anna was the eldest, and she naturally assumed the role of mother. She was the captain of our ship, who charted our course and gently guided us in the direction in which we should go. Because of Anna's directives, we successfully achieved the goals and objectives we set out to obtain. One of the most amazing things the three musketeers had in common was that we all met and married Williams, or Willie, as our men are affectionately called. Grace's husband is Willie, Anna's husband was William, and my husband is Willie. As I mentioned earlier, Grace went on to be the follower and pastor. Anna's husband went on to be with the Lord. Anna has now passed from her pain and suffering, and she is also with the Lord. I'm the only one left with my name. Was that she believed strongly in the dignity of hard work. She gave her best to all the educational institutions where she was employed. Her last post was vice principal at Whitford Primary School, a position she held until she retired. She was one of the best teacher and administrator that the Bahamas could offer. She had a passion for teaching, therefore, she passed on her love of her profession to her one and only daughter, Princess, who is presently the principal of the great city Bethel High School. The entire Bahamian community owe Anna a debt of gratitude for her supreme mentorship skills. Anna might not have received many local or earthly accolades, but I know without a shadow of a doubt, she will receive a crown of gold in heaven. During a period of Anna's life, she was barely able to attend church regularly because her husband, whom she loved dearly, was gravely ill. She was a dutiful and faithful wife who stayed constantly by Willie's bedside. She attended to him even at Montana Hospital in Florida until his death. Anna was a staunch Church of God prophecy member. She always kept a personal relationship with her Lord and Master, and always encouraged Princess Kenny and now Trevor to do likewise. But imagine my surprise when she called me and informed me that she was back on track, attending church regularly, sometimes 3 or 4 times on Sunday, and several times for the week. She gave me more surprising news, and I thought, "Girl Joyce, I not only attend church regularly, but I am now an associate pastor." My response was, "Hallelujah, amen." I know without the shadow of a doubt that my dear friend Anna will be singing the Hallelujah chorus, one of her favorite hymns in the heavenly choir. To my friend Anna, I feel lay so peacefully in this coffin, who never grew weary of doing good and helping others. May you reap your reward.